If you create videos or films like I do, you're going to encounter all types of audio sources, from people speaking to music tracks to sound effects and more. All that noise can make or break your project. On top of that, sound is all around us and can be measured to inform and protect us in our daily lives, as some sounds are not safe. In fact, loud noise can ruin your films and videos and can be very damaging to hearing. The level of noise, where a person is in relation to the noise, in other words, their distance away from it, and the amount of time they listen to it, can all result in risk of hearing loss, which is why we need to understand what decibels are. So stay tuned to the end of this video, because I'm going to give you a detailed explanation of what decibels are when referring to audio. Hi, I'm Jim Costa. I'm a videography, photography, and technology guru, but you can call me a dadographer. I've created many other videos on improving your photography, videography, filmmaking, video editing, audio recording, and technology skills. And I'll link to those in the description below, and both during and at the end of this video as well, so stay tuned. If you want to learn more, remember to subscribe to my channel and hit that bell to be notified when I upload new videos. I upload every week, and I'll be uploading many more explanations of film, video, photo editing, and tech topics. Stay tuned to the end to find out how to get my absolutely free DSLR mirrorless or interchangeable lens video camera cheat sheet that'll have you shooting photos and videos like the pros do in no time. The decibel, abbreviated as dB, is a unit used to measure the intensity of a sound. The decibel scale is a little odd because the human ear is incredibly sensitive. Your ears can hear everything from your finger brushing lightly over your skin to a loud jet engine. In terms of power, the sound of that jet engine is about 1 billion times more powerful than the smallest audible sound. On the decibel scale, the smallest audible sound to a human being, a sound near total silence, is 0 dB. We measure sound levels using a logarithmic scale, which can be confusing if you're not great at math. In general terms, a sound's decibel value is given by the following formula, which is 10 log 10 times I over 10 to the minus 12. I represents the sound's intensity in watts per square meter, which nearly nobody can understand what this means, so let's put it another way. Decibels are a base 10 logarithmic unit, which means that increasing a sound by 10 decibels results in a sound that is twice as loud as the base sound. In my earlier example of near total silence being 0 dB, a sound that is 10 times more powerful is 10 dB. A sound 100 times more powerful than near total silence is 20 dB. A sound that's 1,000 times more powerful than near total silence is 30 dB, and so on. Every time you multiply a sound level by 10, you get another 10 decibels of sound. So a sound that's 10,000 times more powerful than near total silence is 40 dB, because 1,000 times more powerful than 0 dB times 10 equals 10,000. A sound 100,000 times more powerful than 0 dB is 50 dB, because 10,000 times 10 is 100,000, and so on. Basically, for every 10 decibels, you multiply by 10 or just add a zero. Now, if all this math is giving you a headache, you're not alone. I have a headache, and just explaining it, and I actually understand what this means. The simplest way to think of it is that every 10 decibels you go is 10 times louder than the sound before. Here are some common sounds and their decibel ratings. As I mentioned, near total silence, you know, the rubbing of your fingers against one another, super close to your ear, that's 0 dB. A whisper, that's 15 dB. Normal conversation, like I'm speaking now, 60 dB. Your lawnmower is about 90 dB. Car horn, 110 dB. A rock concert or a jet engine, 120 dB. A gunshot or firecracker is about 140 decibels. You know from your own experience that distance affects the intensity of sound. If you are far away, the power is greatly diminished. Of all the ratings that I mentioned above, they are measured when you're standing like right next to the sound source. You know, a plane loud will blow out your eardrums if you're standing next to the jet engine, but if you're 5 miles away, you know, and the plane is up in the air and you're down on the ground, it won't make a difference. It'll sound much, much quieter, obviously. The important thing to remember is that anything over 85 decibels can cause permanent hearing damage. The loss is related both to the power of the sound as well as the length of exposure. You know that you are listening to an 85 decibel sound if you have to raise your voice to be heard by somebody else sitting next to you. 8 hours of 90 decibel sound can cause damage to your ears. Any exposure to 140 decibel sound causes immediate damage and can actually cause pain. Now that I've explained this, I'm going to turn it all upside down. Why? When it comes to mixing the sound for your film and video projects that you're recording, or your album, or whatever it is that you're using sound, you never want the audio to go over 0 dB. Now, I know what I said before, but we're actually talking about apples and oranges here. When you're referring to the level of sound that you hear, the lower the number of decibels, the quieter the sound. However, when you're referring to the level of sound for your videos, it's the inverse. Therefore, 0 dB when you're editing a project is actually the loudest you want your audio to be. Why this is the case is a video for another time. But just know that when editing your projects or recording audio, if you're a musician or whatever you're doing, never go above 0 dB level of your sound and you'll be fine. Now, if all this is making sense to you, but I've got it in the comment section below. My question of the day is, have you ever experienced any kind of audio problems? If so, leave a comment below. Let us know what problem you had and how you fixed it. Would you like to learn more about your camera settings to get you shooting like a pro? I've created an absolutely free cheat sheet for you on all the best camera settings for your DSLR, mirrorless, or video camera that will show you the settings that will allow your photos and videos to compete with the pros. The link to get that cheat sheet is just below in the video description. Best of all, it works great in conjunction with the information that I provided in this video. The cheat sheet will show you how to shoot great video or photos, and this video will help you record proper audio for your videos. I've also created cheat sheets on other topics such as video editing, and even now offer training courses on editing video using Adobe Premiere Pro, which is part of the Adobe Creative Suite. Very soon I'll have others for you as well. I'll link to those cheat sheets and training courses in the description below as well. You want to see more videos like this? Follow my YouTube channel, Jim Costa Films, for many more. Do you think what you saw was great? Like it. Do you have an opinion? Then comment below. Do you know someone who could benefit from the information that I provided? Please share the video. Do you want to learn even more? If so, then connect with Jim Costa Films on social media and online, on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, YouTube, and the web. I currently have over 4,300 videos on my YouTube channel, Jim Costa Films, so feel free to check out many of my other videos for great tips and suggestions. If you follow me for a while now, you may know that I have a community of photographers, videographers, and filmmakers, just like you on Facebook, where I share pro tips and tricks. Called Video Producers and Content Creators. I love new members who want to share their work and learn from others. You'll find a link to that group in the description below as well, so feel free to join it, where you'll learn much, much more.